video for one of the comments I had that was asking that I kind of talk about the shifts and when I shift up the high range or when I shift down low range. So that's what we're going to cover in this video. I will say I may have to recover a gear or two. Let's hope not, but I'm sure it will happen because I'm trying to talk to you guys well. I'm trying to watch all of this equipment and tell you guys what I'm doing to drive this big old Jalopicus down the highway. Can see any better than the last video, which is awesome. So let's give this a try. See it down a little bit. I think we're good to go. I already pre-tripped the truck and the trailer. Everything looks good. We'll pull up. Okay, I'm all ready to get tell you guys. So I'm gonna put the truck in second gear. So that for anybody that doesn't know, when you push this over, there's like a spring there. If I was to go straight up, that would be reversed. Straight down would be first. If I come over kind of like the middle, which is like on the other side of that spring that's over there, straight up is going to be second. Straight down is going to be third. All the way over back over the side where it stops, then you're going to have fourth, fifth. So, and then come back your high range would bring you over, then you would have sixth, then straight up from the middle, seventh, straight down from the middle is going to give you eighth, go over to where it stops, straight up is going to give you your ninth, straight down is going to give you your tenth. So that's all 10 gears. But we're empty, there's no load on the trailer, so I'm going to put this I'm gonna put it in second for this video. Okay, so we'll put it in second. It doesn't hurt. We'll pull out slow. So, all right. So second gear. Yeah, brakes. Brakes are good. Brakes are always good. Check to make sure it's still in here. Pull out in second gear. Because we're just going up a little ways. Check the highway. Just pulling out of the yard now. So in second gear, and we have nada, nothing. Raise our RPMs, shift down to third. Raise our RPMs up, shift up to fourth. Flicker up, bring it over to six. You want to get on the fuel, raise it up, put it into seven, get on the fuel. Raise it up, 1600, get down to eight. We're in the village, so I'm only going to go to nine. Raise it up, and put it into nine. Now we're rolling. Good job, rolling. Okay guys, so you can't see, but I'm coming up on the first turn that we got to make. It's going to be a right hand turn. I'm going about 35 miles an hour right now, but so I'm going to shift down, so I'm going to bring it out, bump it up, bump it in. Now, I'm going to bring it down to your low gears. I'm going about 6 miles an hour. Oh, we got the green light. Yes. Okay, we're at third. Raise the RPMs. Now we're going up a little bit of a hill. bags. And at the end, put it in seven.
Feels, you know, and I'm always using my ears listening to the truck, and
you know, not only just watching the gauges, a lot of times I don't even watch the gauge. I listen to the truck, and usually when I'm not listening, when I'm watching the gauges is when I'll have a grind, because I've tuned my ear to the sound of the truck to know when I should shift most of the time. I think a lot of drivers would kind of agree with me on that, that, you know, the more you drive these trucks, the more in tune and fine-tuned your ear gets to every sound that they make. And I know mine especially, and that's something I started when I first started driving, was just listen to these trucks. They'll talk to you. They'll tell you what they like from what they don't like. And if they don't like it, they're going to let you know. Okay, we're going to have to make another left-hand turn. I'm going to come out of 10. That's a blinker. I might get that green light, guys. 8. Skip over 7. All right, 6. Well, slight grind on 4. And then I'm rolling up. I'm just going to put it in 3rd. I can't go. I got traffic coming. Still got traffic. Shift up to 4th, make our turn. Turn, watch our trailer. Raise those RPMs. Completing the turn. 5th, flicker up. 6th. Now we're going to make a right-hand turn, right up here. It's not that far, so we're going to stay there. There's no reason to shift up another gear because it's such a small section of road. I mean, you could if you want to be like Billy Bigger, I guess. But we're not gonna be Billy Bigger. We got nothing to prove out here but being safe driver. Flicker down. Come out. Shift it into 5th. 4th. There we go. 4th. I wanted 4th, and I didn't listen to what my brain wanted to do because I was talking to you guys, and that's why I tried to go to that other gear. Flicker. So I'm in 5th. Flicker up. Flicker. Shift. It over to 6. See, I could hear it because I'm trying to talk. I knew if I had tried to bring that over, it was going to grind. Okay. Go up to 7. I hope you guys can see what I'm doing. Okay, we got a stop sign, so we're going to come out. 6. Flicker down. 4. Let's get 3rd. 2nd. Here we go, guys. Woohoo! I can do it much better when I'm not trying to talk to you guys, but that's okay. I hope you guys get the gist of it. Okay, so we're going to put it in 3rd. We're going to pull off. We got clear. And we have arrived at our destination. See that? I knew I could feel it. I could feel I need to give it a little bit more to open it up so I can put it in. So I give it a little bit of fuel, open that up, put it in there, because my speed was still all right, but I had to lift my RPMs up a little bit so that I could make everything in the transmission match up so that it would go in smooth. It's understanding how that transmission works, and it's like fingers, like this. If you don't have it right and it's like this, you got to worry about breaking one of those off. Okay, we're at our destination, so I'm going to go check in and we'll get back to this on the way out. Okay, so we'll get back to it on the way out. Okay, guys, sit tight. Okay, guys, we're back ready. Thank you. So now I hooked the trailer and everything, and we got a load on the back. Just pulling off in second gear. Got a slight incline coming out of this place. So definitely want to bring your, make sure those RPMs are up. Down to third. We got a stop sign right up here, so stay there. It's a short little driveway.
Explain it.
That is how it is done. You gotta hill coming up right here, so I'm gonna stay at 9. This isn't a real fast part of the road. That speed limit drops off too. So, and it's pretty steep, so we got a load on the back, so we're gonna put the jakes on, so we'll put them on. Jakes are on. This road's only 50 miles an hour, and it gets steep, so, if you put it, I find if I put it in ninth gear, it's a good gear because the truck, along with the load and the jakes, just walks the whole truck and trailer down the road with minimal braking to get me safely to the bottom without having my brakes heat up or anything like that. And we are heavy, it's full load back there, nice heavy stuff. So right now I'm sitting right about 50. I don't have my foot on the gas, I don't have my foot on the brake. The tractor and the trailer are just walking themselves down the road. So the engine brake is keeping the tractor and the trailer at the speed it needs to be going, which is pretty much what you want it to do. You want the truck to, there's no snow, there's no rain or nothing. So I want to put the least amount of stress on the truck that I can. Now, we're coming up to an even steeper part of the road. And I know it's gonna drop down to 30 miles an hour. So we're gonna drop down to here. We're gonna come down to 8. So if I put it at 8, and I'm going down an even steeper, I know the speed limit is 30 down there. And I'm in 8 here. So I should be able to walk down this hill. 8 will get me up to approximately 35 miles an hour, but I don't even want to go that fast. So I shifted down. I had my foot on the brake a little bit when I came down off here, which gave me a lower speed than that. So I was already about that 35-30 at the top of the hill. So now that I'm coming into the tight turn, I have prepared myself for that speed limit to come down, on top of having the load always pushing me down the hill. And as you can see, I put my foot on the brake, I think once or twice. And just a slow brake, nothing heavy, just a little bit. So nothing to create a ton of heat. Now we're gonna come down, it gets tight through here. It's 30 miles an hour, but it's a kind of like residential tight type of road. So you really don't wanna be flying here. You don't want to have your jakes on either. You know, I don't need them here. We're going into the village. I try to be respectful to the people in the village too. If I don't need them, I certainly wouldn't have them on in a residential area. All right, so we're coming up now. We're gonna make a left-hand turn. So put a blinker on. We're at 7th. We're gonna have to shift down, preparing for that turn. I'm down to 6. Now we'll skip over, bring it down. 4. Skip 5th. Comes 3rd. And we'll roll off. And it'll go right into 2nd. And we're ready to make our left-hand turn when we get the green light. So we got the green light. So now we're gonna come up, raise our RPMs, put it in 3rd, raise our RPMs, put it in 4th, make our turn, walk it out, raise your RPMs. Now you're gonna continue shifting through your gear. So we're in 5th, we're gonna go up to 6. Raise those RPMs and get that road speed up. You don't want to be holding up traffic. That's another thing. You want to get through those gears. Not that you're going to do them, ripping them fast and everything, but you just want to smoothly go through them. You want it to be a smooth thing. When I was learning, a guy told me, you want to shift a truck with like a finesse. And I think in some ways he was right. You do want to. Want it to be smooth and go through the gears. because the more rough you are it, the more jerking you're going to be having around. Not have to be as smooth as ride you can make it. Then shift down, get the green light, shift down to 6, flip it down, 4, skip 5th, didn't need that. I can make the turn in 4th, it's a right hand turn. Now we gotta climb the hill, so what am I gonna do? I'm gonna get those RPMs up, keep them up there, bring it down. There we go, we're in 5th gear. Bring your nose up, bring it over to 6. Now we got that hill pulling us down, so what if we're gonna go to 7, but we're gonna go quick, because we got that hill's pushing us. 8th, we're gonna do the same thing, because now we got that load on the back, and that load is gonna be pushing you down the hill. So if you're going up, it's pulling you back. If you're going down, it's pushing you down. So that's how you have to be watching all this, and knowing, and listening, and all those things that come together that make you so you can shift it smooth. Now we're gonna make a left-hand turn, we'll slow down, shift it up to 7. Got a hill that's gonna be pushing me down. I gotta go, so I'm gonna be quick. See if we can skip over that 5th again, go to 4. Go to 4, see it pushing me down. And then I can roll right up here and put it in 2nd. There we go. Giving a little room so the trucks can make that turn. Now, I got a hill pushing me down here, so I'm going to put it in 3rd instead of 2nd. Because that, what did I say? The load's going to push it. So why make the truck and the trailer work harder than it has to? So we're going to take off in 3rd. Shift it up to 4th already. Make the turn. Shift it down. Made the corner. Now you want to start working through those gears.
Back in here.
that's all for now. I hope you enjoyed this video. I already told you all the stuff. So I guess I'm gonna end this video right about. Yeah, I think right about now, guys. I want to get back to working, and I look forward to seeing you guys in the next video. So take care. Have a good day. Be safe.